Okay, let's discuss about the distribution factor or belt factor. First of all, it comes into the picture that why we are using. We have to know about why we are using this belt factor or distribution factor. There are two types of windings that we can use. First one is distributed winding, and another one is your concentrated winding. So if we talk about concentrated winding, in concentrated winding, coil sides of each phases are concentrated in a single slot under given pole. But in actual practice, the coil sides are not concentrated in a single slot, but are distributed into number of slots. And because of which, the voltage induced in each coil, the voltage induced in each coil sides are not the arithmetical sum, but you can say they are going to be displaced by the phase angle equals to beta of the slots. That is, beta is the angular displacement between two adjacent slots. So overall induced EMF is slightly reduced, and the factor by which overall voltage under each pole, under each phase is reduced, is called as distribution factor, or you can say is called as belt factor, also called as breadth factor. Okay, so if I represent belt factor, distribution factor or breadth factor, then that is called as KD, and this KD is defined as phasor sum of coil voltages, phasor sum of coil voltages, phasor sum of coil voltage, it is better to say only phasor sum of coil voltage to arithmetic sum of coil voltage. Okay, so by the factor by which this arithmetic sum is reducing because of the distribution is called as distribution factor, and that is what we call a KD factor. Now please observe, in a concentrated winding, if we talk about concentrated winding, so in a concentrated windings, in a concentrated windings, the coil sides are concentrated in a single slot under given pole. So please observe what I am saying, concentrated. In a concentrated winding, let us suppose this to be the A phase and this to be the A phase group 1 conductors, that is represented as A, and A phase group 2 conductors. So they are concentrated within a single slot under given pole. Let us suppose we have a 2 pole machine. So for a 2 pole machine, you can say the A phase coils are concentrated in a slot A and A dash. Let us suppose this will be the direction of current in rotor, and this current is DC. Because of this DC current, this will become north and this will become south. For a moment, suppose we are providing the motion in this direction. Okay, so you can say, sir, A and A dash are concentrated. Again, I am repeating, coil side in concentrated winding, each coil sides are concentrated in a single slot under given pole. Okay, similarly, you can say for B phase, the entire B phase coils, or you can say the entire B phase windings, is concentrated in this B and B dash slot. Similarly here, the entire C phase winding is concentrated in a C and C dash slots, where C is, I am going to be say that group 1 conductors, and C dash I am saying group 2 conductors. So this is what we call concentrated winding. Okay. However, in actual practice, the coils are not concentrated but are distributed into number of slots, and therefore the induced EMF that develops in coil is phase displaced by an angle equals to beta degree, that is angular displacement between the slots. Now please observe the distributed winding. Presently I am representing you a three phase winding, distributed winding. Distributed winding. In distributed winding, the coil sides of each phase are distributed into number of slots under each pole. So if you observe
this to be the stator, and let us suppose we have a total 18 slots onto the stator. So if we have 18 slots onto the stator, I can represent 1, 2 or 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17 and 18. Okay. So, let this to be the slot number 1, slot number 2, slot number 3, slot number 4, slot number 5, slot number 6, slot number 7, slot number 8, slot number 9, slot number 10, slot number 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16 and 17, 18. Okay. So, let me do the numberings here. So, it will be more comfortable. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. Let us suppose we have total 18 slots and the machine is of 2 pole. The machine is of 2 pole, it means the rotor windings are bounded in such a way that rotor is of 2 pole. When the number of rotor poles are 2, automatically the number of poles, or you can say stator, is also bounded for the 2 poles. Number of stator pole and rotor poles are always equal in the rotating machine. I have already discussed this in case of induction machines. Okay. So, now please observe. We have this to be the acting as a north and this to be the acting as a south. Now, please observe. You can say, sir, this A phase winding, instead of being in one slot, it is distributed into 3 slots. Similarly, your B phase winding is distributed into 3 slots and C phase winding is distributed into 3 slots. Then again, A phase winding is distributed into 3 slots in this manner. So, it will be little tilted, so it will be more better to represent. Let me do this again, otherwise the EMF polygon will be not formed. So, let me draw this again. Okay, so 1 and 10, two and 3, 4 and 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now, please see. So, we have total 18 number of slots. I am representing here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 1, 2 and 3. So, So you can say, sir, this will become 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, and 18.
So we have total 18 slots, and A phase is in slot 1, 2, 3, then 3 and 3. So, and return conductors are in 10, 11, 12. Similarly, B phase coil side, or you can say C dash coil sides, are in slot 13, 14, 15, and returns are in 4, 5, and 6. Similarly, your B phase is represented by this green one. Is it okay? So, if we have total number of slots to be equals to say 18, for 18 slots, 2 pole machine, 18 slots, 2 pole machine. Now, please observe, I have taken 18 slots, 2 pole machine. So, total number of slots is 18. So, number of slots per pole per phase, 2 pole, 3 phase machine. It is better to represent 18 slots, 2 pole, 3 phase machine. So, 18 slots, 2 pole, 3 phase machine. If you observe here, instead of A phase being in a slot, only one slot, A is distributed into the number of slots. So, that I am representing as here as 1, 2, 3 and 10, 11, 12. Similarly, B phase, C phase and B phase are represented in this way, where this is representing distributed winding. Now, please see, we have this to be the A coil side, that in concentrated winding it is within one slot, but in a distributed winding it is being distributed into the number of slots. So, you can say this is your group 1 conductors of phase A, group 1 conductors of phase A, and this is your group 1 conductors of group 2 conductors, that is A dash, group 2 conductors of phase A. Phase A. So, in the previous case that I have represented as A, and this is represented as A dash. Is it okay? Similarly, this will be your group 2 conductors of phase C, and this is representing group 1 conductors of phase C. That is representing C and C dash. Okay, in a concentrated winding, C and C dash are concentrated in a single slot. However, in a distributed winding, the each coil side is distributed into number of slots. Similarly, this will represent phase B group 1 conductors, that you can say B conductor, and phase B group 2 conductors. Okay, so that can be represented in this way. This is what we call distributed winding. And the angular displacement between two adjacent coil side, two adjacent slots, is called as slot angle, and that is represented by beta. So, you can say, sir, the angular displacement between two center of two adjacent slots is called slot angle beta. So, if you observe this angle, I am representing as beta. Is it okay? This is the angular displacement between two adjacent sides of the slots. Now, please see, if we have 18 slots, 2 pole, 3 phase machine, then first observe M, that is called as number of slots per pole per phase. Number of slots per pole per phase. So, you can say, sir, number of slots per pole per phase is M is equals to, number of slots are, you can say, sir, 18. So, that can be represented as slots per pole per phase. So, you may represent
this M as number of slots per pole per phase here. That number of slots in the presently taken number of slots 18 is 18. 2 pole machine I have taken, so 2. Number of phases is 3. So you can say, sir, this will be equals to 3. Is it okay? So you can say number of slots per pole per phase is 3. That is representing here. 1, 2, 3. Number of slots per pole per phase. If we have rotor of 2 pole, you can say, sir, these are the rotor conductors and they carry DC current, because of which you can say, sir, poles are being formed onto the rotor. So if the current, DC current, is flowing in this fashion, you can say this will be the north and this will be south. So these are the conductors, you can say 3 number of slots per pole per phase, number of slots per pole per phase for 18 slots 2 pole 3 phase machine is equals to 3. I am hoping now you will come to know, you will have the feel about this M, that is number of slots per pole per phase. Okay. Now if you observe the angle beta, that is also called as slot angle. Slot angle is defined as the total angle is 360 degree. Okay. And the slots are equally spaced in this stator surface. So you can say slot angle is equals to 180 upon number of slots per pole. So if we multiply 180 into P, this is 180 is 180 degree electrical. So 180 degree electrical into P will become 360 degree mechanical. 360 degree mechanical divided by number of slots will give you the slot angle. Slot angle is the angular displacement between the two adjacent slots, between the center of the two adjacent slots. So you can say slot angle for this particular case, 18 slots 2 pole 3 phase machine, is 180 into number of poles are 2 upon number of slots are 18. So you can say this will be equals to 20 degree. Yani each of the slots are being 20 degree displaced. Is it okay? Now we know about this number of slots per pole per phase, as well as we know about the slot angle, that is the angular displacement between two adjacent slots of the stator surfaces. Is it okay? Now please see, in case of concentrated windings, the windings are concentrated within a single slot. So all the coils that are in slot A are equally affected by the north pole. Is it okay? However, if the slots are being displaced, then you can say, if you observe the instantaneous voltages, then this will have different amount of flux linkage, this will have different amount of flux linkage, and this will have different amount of flux linkage, due to which you can say the overall phase voltage is slightly reduced, and the reduction in phase voltage is found by this K, is found in the terms of KD, that is called as distribution, or you can say winding factor. Now please observe, the voltages generated in coil sides A 1, 2, 3 and 10, 11, 12, as they are under the influence of north and they are under the influence of south. So you can say, sir, these coils will have, if the motion of the rotor is in this direction, then these coils have induced EMF polarity in the outward side. If the motion of the rotor is in this direction, then these coils have the polarity of induced EMF as outward, and these coils have the polarity of induced EMF inward. Similarly, here also, because this upper surface is acting as a north, this is your magnetic neutral axis, that is quadrature axis, and this is your direct axis. So above this quadrature axis, all the stator surfaces are under influence of north, and below this quadrature axis, all the surfaces are under the influence of south. So you can say, sir, these are also under the influence of north, they carry outward current, and these are under the influence of south, so they carry inward current. Is it okay? Already we have been observed here how the voltages is going to be generated. If the rotor is rotated in this fashion, then you can say, sir, at an instantaneous position of the rotor, this is the induced EMF, and induced EMF is maximum in A phase. However, induced EMF in C phase and B phase are negative half
of the maximum value. Already we have been discussed this. If A phase is 100 volts, then at the same instant B phase and C phase will give 50 volts. Okay. So as the we perform the rotation, then voltage will become in B phase maximum, then voltage in voltage maximum becomes C phase, and so on. So the phase sequence, you found that ACB, A then C maximum, then B maximum. So the voltage phase sequence is ACB. The same voltage phase sequence is obtained here also. However, the voltage, as we have observed in case of concentrated winding, is the same for per phase. Arithmetic sum and phasor sums are same because all the coils of A phase is concentrated within the slots, within a single slot. However, here the number of A phase is distributed into the number of slots, and therefore the voltage generated in each of these conductors are phase displaced by an angle beta. And that can be understood with the polar group formed by the phase. Now please observe, I am representing again 18 slot stator, 18 slot stator. So we have 18 slot stator and 1, 10, 2, 1, 10, 2, 11, 3, Okay, now please see, when the rotor is in motion, then voltage induced across each of the slots becoming maximum when the north is just below that slot. Now let us suppose we have this to be the two pole machine with this is north and this is south. Here I am representing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 3 and 18. Again, I have made some mistake here. I have to draw the 18 slots. Okay. So, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Now the total number of slots are 18. So, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Six, seven, eight, nine. Then you have 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, and 18. So we have total 18 slots. Now please observe, the induced EMF is maximum in the conductor that is in slot number 1 and in slot number 10 when this is the position of the pole. Since the position of the pole is changing, you can say it's better to represent in this way. Okay, if I am representing in this way the direction of motion, then induced EMF in the conductor 2 is going to be maximum after beta degree of rotation from this position. So we can say, sir, it will, the induced EMF in 2 and 11 conductor will be same, but it is displaced by an angle beta degree, that is slot angle, that is displaced in time. Because if it takes, let us suppose, 1 second, then after 1 second induced EMF in 2 and 11 coil sides are going to be same. Is it okay? Similarly, you can say after, say you can after rotating to some more angle, then voltage across this 3 and this 11 or 12 are going to be same. Is it okay? So you can say, sir, if we observe in this fashion, the induced EMF magnitude in each of the slot is the same, but it is time displaced by an angle equals to beta degree of rotation. So the voltages are time displaced by an angle beta degree. Now please observe what I am trying to show you. We have a two pole machine. So when I am saying two pole machine, so one is for the north, another is for the south. You can represent in this fashion. This is north and this is a south. So say this to be the sinusoidal flux, and from the center of the north to center of the south is called as pole pitch, and pole pitch is always equals to 180 degree electrical. Okay. Now please observe how the coils are being placed. The slot number 1 is if under the influence of north, present position of the poles. If slot number 1 is under the influence of north, then this will be your slot number 2, slot number 3 and so on. Similarly, if you observe here, slot number 10 is under the influence of south, and slot number 11, slot number 12 and so on. Then you can also say, sir, slot number 4, which carries C dash phase winding. So slot number 4, slot number 5, slot number 6 and slot number 7, slot number 8, slot number 9, slot number 10, in this fashion. You may represent here also, sir, this will be your slot number, you can say, sir, this will be your slot number 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 and 16, 17 and 18, you may represent here or you may represent it here also. So I am representing on the same side so that we will come to know about the way of winding, how the windings are going to be wounded. 16, 17 and 18. Now please observe. A phase coil side is in slot number 1. First coil side is in slot number 1 and its return coil side is in slot number 10. That is what we call full pitched winding. Okay. Similarly, the coil slot number 2 carries a conductor in this fashion and its return conductor is in slot number 11. So you can represent in this way. And similarly, slot number 3 carries conductor and its return conductor is in slot number 12. Okay. So here I am representing one phase, that is A phase. This entire portion is now called as A, which is in concentrated winding. I have represented A, and this is the, in a concentrated winding, this is called as the return coil side as A dash. Okay. But instead of being concentrated in a single slot, they are distributed into number of slot. So you can say this to be A and A dash side of the coil A. This is your A phase. Similarly, if you observe for B phase, then B phase is, you can say, sir, B phase is, can be represented in this way. Now please see, I am representing it by black so that you can easily identify. This is your ongoing conductor, return conductor. Then again, your ongoing conductor, return conductor is in slot number 14. Ongoing conductor and return conductor is in slot number 15. So this is your B phase. This portion is said to be B, you can say C dash, better to say. This portion is your C dash and this entire is said to be a C. So you can say, sir, C dash C phase winding. Similarly, if you observe B phase winding, then B phase winding can be represented in this format, where this is your overhang. So a B phase can be represented in this way. This will be your B phase winding. Okay. The conductor size is same. However, I have drawn in such a way that it will be clearly visible to you. Okay. So this portion is said to be B and this portion is said to be B dash.
Is it okay? So you can say that this will be B and B dash. Is it okay? So this is a three phase winding which is displaced in space by 120 degree, but instead of being concentrated in one slot, it is distributed into the number of slots. Now if you only observe A phase, we connect this A dash, C dash and B dash are shorted, and A phase, B phase and C phase wires are coming out of the machine that is going to supply the load. Now if you observe A phase, then you can say, sir, if conductor 1, you can say this to be conductor 1, conductor 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17 and 18. Let us suppose each of the coil sides are with a one turn. Okay. So you can say, sir, the voltage generated in conductor 1 and the voltage generated in conductor 10. Voltage generated in conductor 1 is due to the influence of north, and since we are going to rotate in a clockwise direction, so you may say, sir, you may rotate in a clockwise or an anti-clockwise direction, totally dependent upon you. So you can say, sir, if you observe, let it be in an anti-clockwise direction, as in the previous section I have this shown in an anti-clockwise direction. So you can say, sir, if you observe at instant 1, conductor 1 is under the influence of center north and conductor 10 is under the influence of south, center south. So you can say the induced EMF here is outward and the induced EMF here is inward. Similarly, all these conductors are under the influence of north, so they carry current outward, and all these are under the influence of south, so they carry outward current. And therefore, you can say, sir, the polarity of induced EMF can be represented as E1, E2, E3 and E10 with this polarity, E11 with this polarity and E12 with this polarity. So you can say, sir, the total voltage across phase A is equals to E12, you can say in this fashion also, that E12 plus E3 plus E11 plus E2 plus E10 plus E1. However, the magnitude of the voltages are not same. If you consider the magnitude to be same, then they are being time phase displaced by an angle beta. It means when the pole position reaches to this center of this slot, then the voltage across E1 and the time displaced by this is going to be voltage across E2. Is it okay? So if I consider the magnitude of the voltages in the conductor to be same, then they are being time displaced by an angle equals to beta degree of the rotation. Okay. So you can say, sir, the phasor sum and arithmetic sums are going to be different, and so it is better to go with the phasor sum. Is it okay? So if you observe here, let the voltage generated here is E1. Okay, and that I am representing in this direction. See, the voltage generated here is E1, voltage generated here is E2, E3, E4, E5, E6, E7, E8, E9, E10, E11, E12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17 and 18. So if I consider that all the voltages are equal in magnitude, then we can say, sir, the magnitudes are equal, but they are phase displaced by an angle equals to beta degree. So this is E1, E18, E17, E16, E15, induced EMF here in the slot number 14 conductor, induced EMF in conductor placed in slot number 14 is E14, E13, E12, E11, E10. E9, E8, E7, E6, E5, E4, E3 and E2. Is it okay? So you can represent these induced EMF in terms of polygon, as I can represent here. Please observe, I am representing this to be E1. So E1, then beta degree displaced is your E2 from E1. So this will be E2. And then beta degree time displaced is your E3. So I am representing this to be E3. Okay. E4. E5, E6, E5, E4. Okay, E4, E5, E6, E7. Better to represent in a circle so that it will be easy for us. So you can say, sir, the induced EMF generated here can be represented in terms of the voltages generated in a EMF polygon. So E1, E2 phasor, E3 phasor, E4, E5, E6, E7, E8, E9, E10, E11, E12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 17 and 18. We have this to be the E2. So you can say, sir, we may represent this as E1, E2, E3, E4, E5, E6, E7, E8, E9, E10, E11, E12, E13, 14, 15, 16, 17 and 18. So, if you represent the induced EMF in the different slots, the induced EMF in the conductors placed in the different slots can be represented as the EMF polygon, okay? And in this EMF polygon, the two voltages are being beta degree displaced, like E1 and E2 are being beta degree displaced, E2 and E3 are being beta degree displaced in time. So, that can be represented by the EMF polygon. By this EMF polygon, you may represent the generated EMF of a three-phase induction machine. Now, please observe, generated EMF from this EMF polygon, you can say, sir, as M increases, EMF number of slots per pole per phase increases, and therefore, this EMF polygon seems to be a circle. For the higher number of slots per pole per phase, the EMF polygon is going to seem as a circle, okay? Now, please observe here. You can say, sir, why I am explaining this, because this is important for numerical point of view, and you can use the different formula only when if you are able to understand the entire concept. So, I have tried to show you the entire three phase distributed winding. So, if you have a wire, let us suppose the green wire, black wire and blue wire, then you know how we have to going to fix it onto the slots. Is it okay? So, if I give you a slot of a stator, then you can easily perform, you can easily put the windings in a distributed as a three phase, okay. Now, please observe what happens to the voltage generated in the distributed winding. Now, you can say, sir, if we see this to be the E1, so for phase A, E1, E2, E3 and E11, better to say E10, E11 and E12 are the group of phase A conductors. So, if you can represent this as A and this as A dash, then you can say, sir, the voltages E1, E2 and E3 are time displaced by beta degree, and E12, E10, E11 and E12 are also time displaced by beta degree. So, you can say, sir, phase A can be represented as, please observe here, let it be neutral that I have connected A dash, B dash, C dash, okay, shorted this A dash, B dash, C dash. So, the voltage induced E1 phasor, E1 phasor and minus E10, because induced EMF in conductor 10 is due to the south and induced EMF in conductor 1 is due to the north. So, you can say they are time displaced by 180 degree. So, they can be represented as the phasor sum of these two is equals to arithmetic sum. So, E1 plus of E10. E2 is a phase displaced by beta degree. So, you can say this to be the beta degree and this is your E2 phasor. The conductor placed in slot number 2 and the conductor placed in slot number 11 are going to be equally affected by the north and south.
and you can say, sir, the voltages across them is E2 is due to the north, and this magnitude of E2 is equals to E1, but beta degree displaced in time, and therefore you can say E2 and E11 are in, E2 and minus E11 will give you the overall voltage in coil E, in the conductor E2 E11. Similarly, beta degree is displaced from here is your E3, so this will be your E3. E3 phasor is again beta degree displaced, so from this conductor you can say 2 beta degree displaced, okay, and E3 and minus of E12 will give you EA phase, so this will give you A phase voltage, that is EA phase, is it okay? Similarly, if you observe for B phase and C phase, so this portion is representing, this portion is representing for B phase and this portion is representing for B dash. Now please observe. So if this is B, if this is representing B, that is slot number 7, 8 and 9. So the voltage in slot number 7, 8 and 9 can be represented as here as E7. Please observe here. I am representing B phase here as E7, E7 and E7. And the ongoing conductor of B phase is 7, 8, 10, 7, 8, 9 and return conductor is in 16, 17 and 18. So you can say 7, so if we have put it the wire for B phase in slot number 7, then its return will be in slot number 16. So you can say, sir, that is the return will be in slot number 16. So E7 and minus E16 are in the same phase. After 120 degree of rotation, B phase induced EMF is going to be observed from A phase, okay. So from this to be beta degree displaced is your E8 and minus of E17 are in phase, and from this again beta degree displaced, again from this beta degree displaced is your, beta degree displaced is your E9 and E18 minus of E18 are in the same phase. So this will give you induced EMF EB, that is 120 degree displaced from induced EMF EA. Similarly, if you observe CC dash, then C phase conductors are in the slot number, you can say 13, 14 and 15. This is your C, and in slot number 4, 5 and 6 return conductor C dash. So you can say if C phase first conductor is in slot 13, then its return conductor is in slot number 4. So if you observe here, again from E7 to 120 degree time phasor displaced is your E13 and from E7 120 degree time displaced is your E13 and minus E4 are in the same phase. Why I am saying minus? Because after 120 degree of rotation, after 240 degree of rotation, the north is under the influence of, you can say after 120 degree of rotation anti-clockwise, the north is under the influence of C phase, slot number C is under the influence of north, and slot number C dash are in the influence of south. So 13 and 4 are in the same phase. From beta degree displaced is your E14 and E minus of E5 are in the same phase. Then beta degree displaced from here is your E15 and minus of E6 are in the same phase. So this will give you C phase, that is EC phase. This is what we call a time phasor diagram. This is what we call time phasor diagram for three phase machine. So time phasor diagram for EMF generated. Time phasor diagram of EMF generated. Is it okay? So you can say, sir, in the previous section we have observed A phase, B phase and C phase are 120 degree displaced. In this section also we are getting A phase, B phase and C phase to be 120 degree displaced. I think I have represented this in a wrong side, because E4 is this one,
So E4, then beta degree displaced is here, is your E14. E14 and minus of E5 are in the same phase. Then beta degree displaced from here is your E15. E15 and minus of E6 are in the same phase. So this will be your induced EMF EC. I'm sorry for this. So this will be your induced EMF EC. EA, EB and EC are 120 degree time displaced. But in the previous section, the coils under the phase A, one coil side of A phase is concentrated in a single slot. So this EA will be the induced EMF. Okay. However, in this particular case, if you observe, the coil side of A phase is distributed into the number of slots. So the phasor sum of these, which are displaced in time, or you can say degree of rotation as a function of time, is displaced by beta degree. So these are the time phasor EMF generated. Is it okay? Now please observe here what I am saying to be the coil pitch here. Coil pitch is, in terms of number of slots, coil pitch is number of slots per pole. So how many number of slots? We have 18 number of slots and 2 pole. So you can say coil pitch is 9. What do you mean by coil pitch 9? It means one coil side of A phase and one coil side and return coil side of A phase is being displaced by 9 number of slots. So it represents that if one coil side is in slot number 1, then its return coil side, then its return coil side is in slot number, you can say, sir, 1 plus 9, that is coil pitch. So 1 plus coil pitch, so that is equals to 10, slot number 10. Okay, so that is representing the coil pitch. You can say, sir, if we have one coil side is in slot number 1, then its return is in slot number 10. If one coil side is in slot number 2, then its return coil side is 2 plus 9, that is 11. Okay, in that way we can proceed the winding. This type of winding is also called as progressive winding. Generally we design the machine AC machines in a progressive winding. Okay, now please see. You can say, sir, the phasor voltages generated here and the arithmetic sum of the voltages, since we have treated that all the voltages are equal in magnitude, but they are generating after beta degree of rotation, it means you can say they are time displaced by beta degree. So the arithmetic sum of these voltages and the phasor sum of these voltages can be easily calculated, and the ratio of them will representing the distribution factor. In case if all the coil sides are concentrated in a single slot, then this will be have only one, one is for EA and one is your minus of EA. So total will become EA when we add EA and EA dash, as we have observed in case of a concentrated winding voltage generated. Is it okay? Now please observe. You can say, sir, in this particular case, the voltages generated across each of the phase can be calculated as the phasor sum of coil voltages along each. Okay, now please see. For finding the KD ratio, here I am representing the EMF polygon. Please observe, I am representing a EMF polygon. Let us suppose this to be the slot number 1, slot number 2, and slot number 3, slot number 4. So you can say slot number 4. Similarly, here you can say, sir, slot number 10, slot number 11, slot number 12, and slot number 13. So you can say, sir, if we have to find the induced EMF in A across A phase, then that will be equals to E1, E2, E3. You can say E1 plus minus of E10, E2 plus minus of E11, E3 plus minus of E12. So EMF phasor, you can say, let us suppose the EMF polygon in this is E1 is your induced EMF E1, This will be your induced EMF E2, that is beta degree displaced, that is equals to slot angle. Is it okay? So you can say, sir, this will be your slot angle beta. If we take center as a point, then this will be your induced EMF E2 and induced EMF E3. So the phasor sum of E1 plus E2 plus E3 will give you this induced EMF. This you can say, sir, E1 minus of E10, E1 minus of E10, this is your E10, E11, E12. So you can say, sir, if we have to find the phasor sum of one phase, that is A phase, so this will be equals to E1 minus E10, E2 minus E11, E3 minus E12, they are beta degree displaced. If we have to find the distribution factor, that is KD, then KD is defined as KD is defined as phasor sum of coil voltages upon arithmetic sum of coil voltage. So you can say, sir, if we have to find the phasor sum of coil voltage to arithmetic sum of coil voltage, the phasor sum of E1, E2, E3, or you can say the phasor sum of E1 E10, E2 E11, E3 E12 divided by arithmetic sum of E1 E2 E3 or divided by arithmetic sum of E1 E10, E2 E11, E3 E12, the ratios are going to be same. So instead of taking both of the sides under the influence of north or under the influence of south, I am only considering the one pole side. Is it okay? Because the ratio will remain same. The arithmetic sum to phasor sum ratio will remain same. Okay. Now please observe. From one phase, the degree of displacement from one phase to another phase is called as phase spread, and that is represented by M into beta. You can say, sir, the number of slots are from this to this is your beta, beta and beta. So the total will become 3 beta, where we have 3 slots per pole per phase. So phase spread is equals to M beta, where phase spread sigma is called as M beta. That is what we called phase spread. Now what is phase spread? What is phase spread? Now please observe, phase spread is from this phase to another phase, the degree of displacement is called as phase spread M beta. If this angle is beta, then you can say, sir, the total is 1 beta, 2 beta, 3 beta. So this is your M beta. So one phase to adjacent phase, the angular displacement between one phase to adjacent phase is called as phase spread, and phase spread is represented by phase spread is represented by M beta. Now you can say, sir, the total voltage, let this slot to be A, B, C, D. Okay, so you can say, sir, the phasor sum is equals to AD and the arithmetic sum is equals to AB plus BC plus CD. Instead of going in this way, you can also go with that, that is this voltage and this voltage, that is twice of E1, twice of E2 and twice of E3 as the arithmetic sum, and phasor sum is twice of E1 phasor plus twice of E2 phasor plus twice of E3 phasor. So if you find the ratio, then you found that the ratio will remain same. So we can take only half of the portion. Is it okay? Because the ratio is going to be same. So you can say, sir, let this to be M beta. Drop a perpendicular from this center point on this line. If we drop a perpendicular, that is 90 degree, these two lines are the appearing as a radius, so these are equal, and when we drop a perpendicular, then definitely these two sides are equal, these two sides are equal of the two triangles, and two angles are equal, so these two triangles will become isosceles, means all the sides and angles are equal. So you can say, let this be the point F. So you can say, sir, twice of AF is equals to AD. Is it okay? So KD factor can be represented as the phasor sum. I am finding phasor sum of coil, one side coil voltages. Phasor sum of one side coil voltages. Phasor sum of one side coil voltages will become AD. That AD is equals to, you can say, sir, AD is equals to 2AF. Okay. When we drop this perpendicular F, then this angle will become M beta by 2. Okay. So, you can say, sir, you may represent this 2OA sine M beta by 2. Because this is a right angle triangle, and this right angle triangle, if this angle is m beta by 2, this will be your perpendicular and this will be your hypotenuse. So, you can say, sir, OA sine of m beta by 2 is equals to OA by AF. So, AF will become OA sine m beta by 2. Is it okay? Now, again observe here, the phasor sum of coil voltages is equals to 2OA sine m beta by 2. Now, arithmetic sum of coil voltages. Arithmetic sum of coil voltages is AB plus of BC plus of CD. And I have considered that all will have the equal in magnitude. Only they are being time displaced by beta degree. So, you can say, sir, this will be equals to M times of AB, where M is the number of slots per pole per phase. So, you can say the sum of one side coil voltages, the sum, arithmetic sum of one side coil voltages is equals to M into AB, and AB is drop a perpendicular from this point, center point, to AB. So, when we drop a perpendicular, again you can say, sir, these two sides are equal, these two sides of the triangle will become equal. So, you can say these two will become equal. Let this point as say N. So, you can say, sir, AN is equals to NB in magnitude, and this angle will become beta by 2. Is it okay? So, you can say, sir, that can be represented as twice of AN, where AN can be represented as twice of AN can be represented as, again this is a right angle triangle. So, in this right angle triangle you can say OA sine beta by 2, OA sine beta by 2. So, we can use a simple geometry to find the one side coil voltages. The ratio of phasor sum of one side coil voltages upon arithmetic sum of one side coil voltage is equals to phasor sum of coil voltage upon phasor arithmetic sum of coil voltage. Because the two sides of the coils are equally in magnitude, and they are displaced by 180 degree in phase, time phase. Is it okay? So, you can say, sir, we may represent the KD factor as arithmetic sum of coil voltages to phasor sum of coil voltages as KD will become equals to, now please see. KD is equals to phasor sum of coil voltages is OA 2OA sine M beta by 2. Is it okay? And arithmetic sum of coil voltages is 2MOA sine beta by 2. This is one side of the coil voltages. For two sides of the coil voltages, you may multiply it by 2. So, that is not going to affect the ratio KD. So, you can say, sir, KD is equals to this OA, OA and this 2, 2 will be cancelled out, and this will become sine M beta by 2 upon M sine beta by 2. This is okay. So, that is what we call distribution factor. So, from this distribution factor, we come to know that the coil voltages, or you can say voltage induced across each phase, okay, in a distributed winding. So, this KD, this is for the fundamental. This is for fundamental. As previously we have been observed that for nth harmonic, theta electrical for nth harmonic is equals to n times of theta electrical for fundamental. So, you can represent
kd for nth harmonic is equals to sin m n beta by 2, where beta is in electrical degrees, upon m sin n beta by 2. This is for nth harmonic component. This is for nth harmonic component. Okay. Sometimes you may also represent that kd in terms of phase spread. So, you can say, sir, kd in terms of phase spread, in terms of phase spread, in terms of phase spread sigma, where sigma is equals to m beta, in terms of phase spread, kd for fundamental is sin phase spread by 2 upon, you can say, sir, m sin phase spread by 2m. Is it okay? In case if you found that, this beta is lower than 15 degree, then in that particular case, you can say sin beta by 2 is equals to beta by 2 in radian. If this beta is less than or equals to 15 degrees. Now, please observe here. In case if beta is less than 15 degree, if beta is less than 15 degrees, then you may represent kd is equals to sin m beta by 2 upon m beta by 2 in radian. So, you can say, sir, we may represent this as sin m beta by 2 is sigma by 2 upon sigma by 2 in radian. Okay. You can say, sir, if beta is less than 15 degree, then sin 15 by 2 is 7 degree. Sin 7 degree is same as 7 in radian. If you convert 7 in radian by multiplying it pi by 180, then you found the values of 7, sin 7 and 7 in radian is same. So, that is why I have represented in this way. Okay. You can say, sir, in terms of beta, m beta, or in terms of phase spread, both for fundamental component. This formula is for fundamental component. For fundamental component. Okay. Now, if you observe the distribution factor for nth harmonic component, then this will become sin n phase spread by 2. Sin n phase spread by 2 upon n phase spread by 2 in radian. Is it okay? This is for nth harmonic component. For nth harmonic component. Okay. You can also calculate this in this way also. You can say, sir, even phasor at an angle 0. Or you can say, if I take even as a reference, then even at an angle 0 plus E2 at an angle beta plus E3 at an angle plus E3 at an angle 2 beta and so on upon E1 plus of E2 plus of E3. Why I am saying this? Because the two are equal. You can say, sir, phasor sum of coil voltages, you may represent in this way also. Phasor sum of coil voltages is E1 at an angle 0 plus, or you can say minus of E10 at an angle 0 plus of E10 at an angle 180 plus of E2 at an angle beta plus of E11 at an angle 180 beta plus 180 and E3 at an angle 2 beta plus of E 10, 11 and 12, E12 at an angle 2 beta plus 180 and so on divided by, you can say, sir, we may find in this way also, that is equals to E1 magnitude plus E10 magnitude plus E2 magnitude plus E11 magnitude plus E3 magnitude plus E12 magnitude. The ratio will remain same even if we calculate as E1 at an angle 0 plus E2 at an angle beta plus E3 at an angle 2 beta upon E1 plus E2 plus E3. So, that I have done. Is it okay? So even E2, E3 are equal in magnitude, but I have considered that they are being time displaced by an angle beta degree. It means when north, when the slot comes under the influence of just below the north pole, then the voltage will be induced EMF. Okay, that we have taken E. So for nth harmonic component, you can say, sir, sine n sigma by 2 upon n sigma by 2 in radian. But all of these formulas are valid for the fractional integral slot winding. Now, what is integral slot winding and fractional slot winding? Focus. Now, let us focus about the integral slot winding and fractional slot winding.